Welcome back to another ORM Mastery tutorial. Don't forget you can access all the tutorials in this course. There is a link in the video description. And of course, if you love this course, then you can go ahead and use our link in the video description to get the best price for our Udemy course. Well, more often than not, the reason why we explicitly define an intermediate model is because we want to extend the model and include additional fields. In this tutorial, we learn how to create the custom fields within an explicitly defined intermediate model, but more important, we learn how to actually query the table. More specifically, how to add data to that intermediate table when we have specified those additional fields. If you were wondering, we are going to be utilizing all these skills in a later tutorial where we start to actually apply what we've learned here and refactor the e-commerce database, as well as utilize these skills in further projects. So here, let's just go through the basics. And like I'm alluding to there, we will be utilizing all this information in more context later on in this course. We'll keep this example simple by adding a new field. So this is in our inventory models. So we'll add a new field. Let's call this ordering or order equals. And let's go for let's go for an integer field. Okay. There isn't any particular reason for this field. You can add as many fields as you like. This is just to showcase and for us to learn the basic underpinning knowledge here. So we have a field here, order field. It's an integer field. Let's go ahead and migrate this data. So notice that we already have data in the database here. So we're probably going to go for a complete reset. So I'll go ahead and I'll delete the table. Now, this code is available. This may or may not be there. So let me just close that, cancel. Okay. Let's move that to the bin and then just make sure you delete the migrations, of course. So let's just go for a reset. So do that run again. So make migrations and then we go ahead and migrate. My fingers are too thick. That's what the problem is there. Okay. Let's get back into the shell. Okay. And let's bring in our resources. Again, you're going to find the queries MD file for this. So we are going to need to, from the e-commerce inventory models, let's import category, product, and then product underscore, category. Okay, so we import that in, as well as importing OS. And then we go ahead and we'll just clear this to make some room. Right. So let's go ahead and add some data now to our database because we've completely renewed our database. There is nothing in our database at the moment, as you can see there. So let's add product one and product two. So product one, and we'll go ahead and bring in product two. So we'll go ahead and save product one. And then we'll save product two. So product two, save. Okay, so you can see that's everything now in the products table. So that should give us two products. Happy days. All right, so let's go ahead and make a new category. So I'm just going to save that straight away. So cat one, one category. This is what we performed. This is the same queries that we performed in the previous tutorial. Right, so we run that. And now we should have a category in the category table. Right, so we can just double check, of course. Let's go into our Explorer. I think, there we go. Okay, so we've got nothing inside of our inventory product intermediate table, but we have our product table. Okay. What's going on here? There we go. So we have our product table, two products, and then we have our category table. Okay. Right. So let's go ahead now and build a new entry inside of our intermediate table. So first up, let's grab an instance from product. So grab product one from the product table. And let's go ahead and just grab category one as per normal. Right, so now what we need to do is to assign this or to build that relationship between these two items. If you remember previously, we ran product one or prod in this case, and then we went ahead and added that to the link table through category there, cat one. So that's one way of us performing this. Now, of course, in this case, what we have is additional fields. So we need to specify those fields. So let's go into our models and just check the fields that we need to utilize. So there's two fields here, product ID and category ID. So we simply just need to explicitly define this data. So let's manually type this out. So we've got product category add, and then product ID is going to equal product, the instance that we're storing here in product. And then we need a comma in between. So then we have category ID that equals the instance here in cat. And then we need to also then pass in the order. So order equals, and that could just be one. So here then we have an unexpected keyword argument, product ID. So I wasn't expecting that error, and it is completely my fault. So I do apologize. Let's do this again, right? So what we need to do here is, in actual fact, I'll show you that example in a minute. I wanted to show you a previous example. What happened was my fingers was typing one example, but I was actually thinking of a previous example. So we'll do this one more time. So in actual fact, we want to be direct. So the product category table. So we're just going to use product category dot objects. We're just going to use create. So this is just one method. So here we're going to explicitly define, like we saw previously, we're going to explicitly define all the fields. So let's do that again in actual fact. Right. So product category objects.create, product ID, category ID, order. Okay, let's give this a go. And there we go. So we've now added this in a traditional way, utilizing the create function. Right, so let's go into the correct table, product category table here, show this table. And you can now see we've added that over into our intermediate table here, including the additional information in the order field. So we can check that. Let's grab the product instance that we were working with previously to save that data. And let's go over to category all. So we're going to select all the categories associated with this instant prod, which is obviously product ID one behind the scenes. So if we grab that, we can see that we return category one. Okay, so back to the other example. So we can use add, create, or set to actually develop data within this table. So let's just go through an example utilizing add. So let's build a new category. Okay, so we have category two now. So one and two. So let's go ahead and associate category two to product ID one. Utilizing the add function. Right, so to do that, we have cat two. Okay, so we've got cat two. So we're going to say product. Now behind the scenes, we do have product that refers to the instance of product ID one. Okay, so if you don't, just run a quick get for that, if you like. I'll just show you again. So we can get this instance. Okay, so that's prod. That's our instance. So we can now say prod category. So we want to add or associate it to a category dot add. So here what we do is we pass in the category, which is category two, and then we use through defaults. So we define some through defaults, and these will then be added to the fields that we specify. So we've got the order field. So we're going to specify in there the value one. And there we go, that's about it. So don't forget the ending the parentheses there. Press enter. You can see that we've got unexpected keyword argument through default. And the reason why that is because we've forgotten the S. So it's through defaults. And there we go. So not null, constraint failed. Inventory product category, category ID, ID. Okay, so it looks like we've got some integrity errors here. And the reason why that is because when we created the category, I utilized a one-liner with the dot save at the end. You may have saw me do that. So for example, I used this command here. So it wasn't actually saved in cat 2. I think that's what the problem was. Okay, so let's just go ahead and grab cat 2. So say cat equals category objects cat 2. So it returned two items. Okay, name is cat 2. How bizarre. Because there's only one in the database. Okay, so now I've got two. Okay, so I've made too many items here. So I've made too many items in the database there. I pressed it too many times. So let's just start again, right? So let's just clear this and start again. Okay, right. So let's grab the cat instance. That's going to be cat 2. Okay, let's grab the product instance. That's going to be product 2. Let's just double check we've got product 2. Yep, product 2 exists. Cat exists. So the problem we had before was the way that I created the category, it wasn't saved in the variable, I think, cat 2, as we were using. So that caused an issue. So let's go back there. And now let's go in and create using add. So we have cat and prod. Okay, so therefore we have a new query. So prod, that's referring to our product 2, I think it is, category.add. Cat is referring to category 2 now, and then we define our three defaults. So our additional fields order should equal 1. So we give that a go. You see that it is now successful. So let's go back into the category table and show. You can now see we've added the new entry in our table. Apologies if that wasn't very clear. Do have a go at adding some additional data. Utilize the queries file here. Which will have all the commands or the commands that we've utilized here. So just experiment. And in addition to that, you could also extend that slightly, have a look at add, create, and set to define data within your tables.